title is alone to be close to you. The title alone speaks of the desire of intimacy, right? With whom? With God. Amen. You guessed it right. This must be the desire of each and everyone whose life is broken over sin. We must long for God more than anyone and more than anything. For God is not only our healer and our savior, but he is our very life. He's our life. We cannot exist apart from him who gives you air to breathe. God! Okay? God, amen? Okay, so apart from God, we are nothing. So don't believe, especially when we are young, we think we have the same strength tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow. Wait till you get old. Then you realize, I need God more. Amen, right? Amen. Ato tayo pa nung nanay din eh. Mom Ed? Ako si Spencer. Mom Ed is not mom na mom. Mom, M-O-M. Mom Ed na. Amen. Nino? Namading? Amen. We need God the more, especially when we get older. Allow me to share to you the words of Jesus written in the scripture. In here, Jesus talks about life, that a good life and eternal life is found in him alone. John 3:36, 1-3.
Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life, but whoever rejects the Son will not see life, for God's wrath remains on him.
Next, John 5:24. John 5:39. John 6:48. Let me go back in John 3:36. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. Whoever rejects the Son will not see life. Jesus is the most rejected one in this life. Do you know that? We seek other things. We seek other God. We seek other people, but not Jesus Christ. Remember this. Who died for your sins and mine, and for the sins of every mankind? Jesus. Who is the God who came from heaven to earth, lived here a perfect life, and died for our sins? Do you know any other God who came from heaven and died for our sins? None, no? Wala. So it is the only one. He is the only one. So if we reject Jesus Christ, God's wrath, God's the Father's wrath, yan kasukok ba? His anger is towards us. So no matter how much we cry, Jesus will not listen to our cry because we do not recognize his Son, the only Son. He gave up his only Son for us. So if you receive Jesus Christ, John 5:24 says, Jesus, this is the word of Jesus. I tell you the truth, whoever hears my word and believes him, the Father who sent me, has eternal life and will not be condemned. Meaning, you are not under his judgment anymore. You're not going to hell, but going straight to heaven even when you die. Because he said, he has crossed over from death to life. While you are here, if you receive Jesus Christ, immediately you will not go to heaven. But if you refuse to receive Jesus Christ, we go straight to that greatest death, experience of death, second death in hell. That's why Jesus Christ was saying to the Pharisees, you diligently study the scriptures because you think that by them you possess eternal life. They know the Bible, and many know the Bible. Jesus Christ said, these are the scriptures that testify about me, yet you refuse to come to have, you refuse to come to me to have life. You know, intellectual ascent or intellectual relationship with Christ will not make us to heaven, will not give us the privilege to go to heaven. It must be turned into an actual Christian living. Our life must be changed. We need to forgive. We need to release forgiveness. We need to acknowledge when we sin. We need to love even if they don't love us. These are the hard facts of life that is very difficult if you will not have the Spirit of God in you. And the Spirit of God will come upon you if you receive Jesus Christ. He will be the one working in each and every one of us. That's why Jesus Christ said, I am the bread of life. He is the very food we need in this life. Amen? So allow me to sing this song to you.
Don't ever let me go. Lord.